Hey, welcome to March. February is finally over, which is awesome. I always say it has the shortest amount of days because it sucks the most. Did you know more people kill themselves in the month of February than any other month? Which is why, thank goodness, it's the shortest month, but then also why I felt it was super important in March to have this reading center around our happiness, okay? So there are a lot of reasons why people watch these videos, but at the very core of it, I think that people are watching because they want some good news, right? They want something to look forward to. In the words of Omar Suleiman, a very wise guy, he says that the keys to happiness are three things: something to love, something to do, and something to look forward to. So hopefully I'm going to give you all of those in this reading. So even if your life is already full of joy and happiness and bliss, if you're just wanting to hear some validation about these good vibes that you're already feeling, that, you know, to hear you're already on the right path, that you're making the right choices, the right decisions, for that sense of security, security does bring happiness, right? Knowing what to expect. At the end of the day, happiness is what we're all seeking. It's the reason why we seek out help, why we would use a tarot reader, why we would look up our horoscope. This is why we're doing this, okay? We are fiends for happiness. It's the ultimate drug. And so this is what we're focusing on in March. So this will be for your sun, moon, or rising sign. A lot of times, because our moon sign correlates to our emotions and how we feel, which is a lot of times why we make the decisions we make, that might resonate a little bit better for you. So it might be advisable to watch your moon sign as well as your sun sign. And then you could do your rising sign as well, too, if you'd like to. What did I want to say? Okay, so since we're focusing on happiness for March and how to kind of sustain that throughout the year, this is how we're going to look at it. We're going to do... where are you at right now? What is tainting any feelings of happiness that you otherwise should have right now? What will make you feel happy, or at least what you think will? How is that perception true? How is that perception false? What will actually make you the most happy this month? And then we're going to look at the forces that are kind of outside of your control, right, that is affecting this state, and which ones that are not really within your power are kind of accelerating your happiness, and then which ones are decelerating that. We're going to look at what's going to bring you luck this month, your crystal of the month, your color energy, your lucky days, and then also any energies that you need to kind of bring into your life in order to help the happiness thrive, how to sustain the happiness once you get some, and then just kind of like a recap or overall nutshell of what March will look like for your sign. So kind of thinking about, you know, okay, well, is this reading going to be enough because it's for each specific zodiac sign? Each sign has their own. Then I was thinking, those of you who have followed me for a long time might remember stop, drop, roll readings, where it's something that you stop doing, something you drop from your life, and something you should roll with. I think I'm going to do a special on those, but really kind of amped up or accelerated in order to really harness in on that happiness sort of life coaching aspect. And the reason why I think this is important in March is because, number one, it's the perfect time for spring cleaning, right? Number two, the popularity of Marie Kondo right now, and, you know, sort of thinking about, let's get rid of the things that don't bring me joy. Let's just focus on the things that bring me joy. And, you know, we all are always looking for joy. We're either trying to increase pleasure or decrease pain. And so that's kind of the purpose of this reading. And then here's the other thing. We're about to step into this Mercury retrograde. We're in the pre-shadow period right now as I record this. And so then when it hits us, in order to use this time in its fullest potential, we want to very much evaluate, okay, this isn't working for me. I want to pitch this and I want to do something that's going to make my life better. It's going to make me happier. It's going to make me more joyful, more satisfied with life. And so I think I'm going to offer that like in sort of a goals and coaching, very intensive sort of way as a special. Once I decide to do that, if you're on the email list, I only send one email a month, so don't let that be a reason why you're not on my list. Then you'll be notified of that. And if there's like a coupon code or something, that would be in there. If you're not on the list, you should be, because I give away, like I said, it's only one email a month, but every single month I give away a free 20-minute video reading to a random person selected from my list. So that being said, I'm sorry if this long intro did not bring you joy, if it decreased your happiness, but now you know what to expect in your reading. So let's get started. Hey Scorpios, welcome to March. I know you're like, March is half over, why are you just doing this now? Because I had stuff going on and I'm sorry. Also, Mercury retrograde makes things go slower than you expect, which is totally the case with these readings. A lot of them were like 25 minutes, which is not what I expected. Anyway, let's get right to it. Where are you at right now in the month of March? And they're saying you're deep in your feelings. Well, that's you always, right? But they're saying some of you have lost something or let something go, whether that was a job, whether that was a relationship, but it was something serious that was a part of your life for a while. Now, for those of you who are like, that doesn't make sense, you're just sad because you're sad. You're just like bummed out. Maybe some of you have let go of some sadness, actually, that it was long withheld. You know, like you're finally over something. You've let that go. And so they're saying, you're probably actually surprisingly, even though you're in your feelings, feeling more okay and good about things, like in a positive way, putting yourself first for the first time in a while. They're saying that like there's not a lot of exciting things going on right now, which is the case for Leos as well. So if you have a Leo Scorpio kind of chart, it'd be interesting to see that. But you know, you're feeling more confident as far as the projected outcomes in your life. Like, you know that you're going in the right direction. So this is all really good stuff. What's tainting any feelings of happiness right now? And they're like, other people who talk too much. Other people who like send too many text messages, emails, like anything that feels redundant or annoying, that they're reaching out, you know, and like the reason why they're doing it is just a waste of your time. Some people are just like kind of also messaging, sending electronic messages, because this is reaching out, not by phone call. It's like by text message or email or Facebook. So anyway, that kind of a thing, Facebook Messenger, you know, electronic text communication. They're saying some of the things that people are maybe even saying are hurtful or harmful to you in one way or another. And it doesn't necessarily mean that they meant for you to interpret it that way. You might be interpreting it that way, but they might also just be rude. So for example, if you are on a dating app, maybe somebody says, you look so cute in this picture where you're smiling, but like in your other pictures, you know, you should just smile in all of them or something like that. And so maybe they meant it as constructive criticism, but it bums you out and it hurts, kind of a thing. What is it that you think is going to make you happy in the month of March? And they said, like, whenever you're feeling like you're a little bit down in the dumps, that you're not very good at something, that you're able to shift your mindset and you think that that's going to help you to be happy, that it's just like, you know, that control over not the thoughts that you have, but the ones that you adopt and carry forward. So how is this true? They're like, you know what? You can't avoid pain at all. But when you're able to, you know, take an action of some sort, this is true. This is totally true. They're like, you can't avoid disappointment generally, you know, in the world. It's going to happen. However, the steps that you take, the ideas that you have, or like, for example, when I'm bummed out, when I'm feeling kind of depressed, I like to just lay on the couch and watch like 1,000 episodes of a series of a show. And I know I should get up and get some work done, or I know that I should, you know, move the laundry into the washing machine and then, you know, to the dryer while I'm sitting there, but I don't do it. And so if you take that control and you just kind of like launch, like, is it Mel Robbins who has the like 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 blast off kind of stuff to get out of depressive, you know, bad negative spirals, making those instant decisions, that'll really help you. You're absolutely right, at least this month. But how is your perception false? And they go, well, it really isn't, because you know that you feel better when you stand up and move around and like you actually start doing something. Once you get into the flow of doing something, you're gonna feel better. So you're absolutely right. Your intuition is spot on, which is typical for a Scorpio. So what is going to make you the most happy this month? And they say general successes, like wins in your life. So that could be anything from compliments. This could be job promotions. This could be a pay raise. This could be like an actual lottery win. This could just be somebody patting you on the back and saying, good job. You know, coming out of your shell and interacting with people is also going to make you really happy. More social interaction this month is really, really good for you. So the forces at play outside of your control in favor of your happiness are you having maybe a little bit extra money to spend on yourself to indulge in self-care or maybe some time for that, understanding it's important that your emotions are generally like pretty in check. You don't have any like crazy kind of energy stuff going on with the retrograde this month. And then an increase in confidence for one reason or another, which will lead to an increase in, you know, deepening friendships, meeting new people, having more fun. So good for you. Yay. I'm happy about this because I'm a Scorpio moon. So, whoop, whoop. Forces at play outside of your control against your happiness. And they go, well, some people are going to lie. You know, some people are going to lie to you, especially about, you know, for example, if you are not a coupled person, if you're looking for a partner, people are going to lie and say, hey, I'm looking for a long-term relationship because they know that you are, maybe just to sleep with you or something like that. Or it could be because this energy is about the long term, lies about the long term. It could be your workplace lying about, you know, we'll just stay here because, you know, 2 years from now, this position is going to open up and, you know, it's going to triple your money and we want you to take that role. And it's like, no, they just don't want you to quit and they know they're underpaying you right now because they think you're going to stick around. There's some sort of lie about a long term outcome. Okay. So be wary of that because that'll really upset you. What's going to bring you luck this month? So this month for you, the 3rd of March was one of your luckiest days, but then the other lucky day, which hasn't already passed, is the 21st. So if there are things that require your luck, if you could schedule those for the 21st, that would be ideal. And then your color energy of the, actually, I'm going to skip that and I'm going to go to your crystals of the month first. So you have two of them. You have the black tourmaline, as well as red jasper. So I have three different ones here because I wanted to show you how much they can vary. So this is in the raw form, and then this is what it looks like when it's tumbled. So it could be striped or it could be, you know, pretty solid, but then you can see like a few little stripes in there. So there are different variations of that, just so you know, if you're looking through your own rock collection, do I have that? Then you know. And I call them rocks, even though they're crystals or gems, because I like to call them magic rocks. But anyway, this isn't about me. This is about you. So tourmaline, this one is really good for grounding. It repels negative energy. This one I like when I don't use this one very much. And the reason why a lot of people don't know this, but is it if you carry it on your skin, like if you have it on a necklace or something, if you hold on to it too much, it makes you fat. It's an anti-anorexic, therefore increases your hunger, and therefore you have problems stopping overeating. Like constantly, you're constantly hungry, you gain a lot of weight when you wear these. So, that's actually one of the reasons why, if you don't have a crystal and you don't have like a local rock store nearby, but this is something you're interested in, why you should get one from me instead of, you know, willy-nilly. Because I'll give you all that information with your crystals when I send them out, and then you also get a playlist. And like a bunch of videos on different ways that you can use them to your advantage. So anyway, what I wanted to talk about here is this, it kind of helps you to not go crazy. It like you know how sometimes when you like emotionally spiral, like I said, it's protective, it alleviates stress and tension, especially if you're feeling overworked. It gives you a lot of like clear-mindedness and logic, kind of like a throat chakra, like a blue stone would do. It does a lot more things, but that's what I just basically wanted to kind of recap with you quickly. Then your red jasper in whatever form that you might have it. This one is also very protective. They're both correlated to the root chakra, okay? This one will help you with dream recall and like if you like to astral plane when you're dreaming and stuff like that. Both of them will pick up electromagnetic energy. That's what I was saying. When I do use these, is I put them usually like by my computer or my microwave or by my television because it does pick up all of those negative ions. Okay, so anyway, this one helps you in moments of conflict. It creates these feelings of like self-honesty, looking at the truth. It makes you courageous, that like warrior spirit.
helps you to complete projects. It's really lucky and good fortune for you when you're traveling. So that's good stuff. It helps to create balance in relationships to make them mutually beneficial so that one person isn't like sucking all the joy and happiness out of somebody else, that sort of a thing. Now, as far as your color energies go, your power colors, you have two, and one isn't really a color. It's, I like to call this one sparkles. So if you use color rays to heal, like in a meditation or something, like I usually imagine them coming from my crown chakra, going through my body and cleansing me. Although you can use them in different places based on what they do. So the first one, the rose, this would correlate to the heart chakra. This one says attracting a new relationship. And this doesn't have to be a romantic relationship if you're already happy in a relationship. This could just be attracting a really close new bestie or something like that. Or strengthening the relationships that you already have. Whereas the other one, it's called brilliance, okay? But I imagine this one as like almost sparkles in my auric field, okay? So rose, it's a number 6. So remember when we talked about with the red jasper how it can create balance and mutual beneficence in relationships? Same kind of vibe here. So with this one, it's the color of romance, you know, deep attraction, sometimes lust, affection. So those kind of things in relationships, if you're desiring those, this will help you to bring that to you. You can actually imagine a rose light kind of coming out of your heart chakra, trying to connect with, like shooting out like, you know, like a lighthouse would, light from your heart chakra to connect to a new partner, if that's what you're searching for. So anyway, with this one, you can write everything down in a rose-colored pen. You can wear this color, but it'll still work for you. So what this does then is it helps you to awaken your heart, you know, to really open that up, clear away any blockages you have. And then the affirmation for it is, I'm open to attracting wonderful people with open minds and loving hearts into my life. Isn't that beautiful? I love it. Okay, so then the one that it's actually called brilliance, but I like to call it sparkles, as you know. So this one, oh, cute. It says discover your sparkle. I didn't even know that. So especially if you're using the rose one to attract a new mate, this will very much help you to appear to be very extra shiny and sparkly. You know, well, you'll just stand out in a crowd. That kind of energy where you walk into a room and everybody notices, this is going to happen or help you with that. So 2 is like balance in your own self. 6, balance in relationships, but combining to be an 8 with great speed. So doesn't matter that it's actually a Mercury retrograde for you. This might be a really great time for you to attract a new mate, even if you want to start really seriously dating them after the Mercury retrograde, because you're suspicious about starting new things, but this is a really great energy to help you with that. So this one is all about change and transformation. This one helps you kind of like clear your energy, clear away blockages, like wipe the slate clean. So if you were one of those in the beginning of this reading where it's like, okay, I'm finally over a bad relationship or something like that, you know, I finally let this go, you can clear away any debris left over, anything residual that you're carrying along, which the energy is perfect for in a Mercury retrograde. That's the point. And then you're like the shiny new you that goes out there and gets what you want, that you have this like magnetism to you. So this one helps you to release fear and anxiety when you're feeling heavy or depressed. Like kind of imagining this sparkly white light coming through you is really, really helpful. It can heal a lot of health conditions as well. So anyway, the affirmation with this one, I'm ready to recognize my own wisdom and follow my brilliant ideas to manifest and inspire all of those around me. So how cool is that? Yay! Okay, so back to the reading. What kind of energies do you need to bring into your life to help happiness thrive there? And they're saying that self-care, putting yourself first, really loving yourself. And you can do self-care by buying yourself things, getting your nails done, taking a long bath, taking, you know, time by getting a babysitter so you can read a book for a half hour, you know, whatever. Everybody does that a different way. How are you going to sustain the happiness once you get some? And they go, honestly, it's just about being open to receive it. It's not a problem of the continual flow of it, because the universe, God, spirit, whatever, wants to give you things right now. So as long as you're open to receiving the blessings from the universe, from friends, whatever, compliments, you know, free lunches, whatever it is, you'll continue to get those. So good. And that will make you happy so long as you don't feel guilt or shame for accepting gifts. And then March overall, in a nutshell for you, like, they're like, okay, think about what you want. I'm getting goosebumps because this is so fucking magical. Ah, I'm so happy. Okay, so this is the problem. Some of you don't know what you want. You don't know what you're trying to manifest. Therefore, you're not manifesting anything. This is saying, the star card, I always call it the wish card because it's like wishes fulfilled. But the wishes are bigger and more beautiful and better than you even thought possible. So you might put like a couple wishes out there, and now that you're like really balanced emotionally and on the earthly plane, like you have a good idea. You know the difference between when you're overreacting and like what reality is and what is rational, okay? Because you've achieved that, now you're going to be blessed in so many ways. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 gifts, 8 blessings coming your way, 8 wishes fulfilled. So it's like, I might put out 7 wishes, 7 things that are important to me, 7 things that I want to manifest into my life, and then get this 8th thing that's like the icing on the cake that is way better than anything I even imagined. And so they're saying the only thing that you have to really do here is think about what it is that you want. You know, and so I use this analogy all the time, so you're probably sick of it if you've been around for a while, but it's like you don't call up Domino's and go, hey, I want a pizza for delivery. Click. They could either not bring you the pizza because they don't know what you want. They might bring you the wrong pizza. They might look in your file and see what you ordered before, but that might not be what you want, because what if that was your ex's favorite pizza? You know, and like in a Mercury retrograde, that's why exes come back. Like, what are you manifesting, really? So place your order. If you want something specific, if you're like, today I want cheese pizza with pineapples on it, you have to be specific, so that's what shows up at the door, you know? So that's what they're saying. Really get it written down, pen and paper, what it is that you want in all areas of your life, in your health, in your love life, in your family, as far as your career goes, your work-life balance, like, you know, actual even things that you desire. Like, maybe there's a handbag that you want, write it down. Because you know what? Even if it's like $2,000, which is extreme amount of money for most people, for a handbag, you might end up being gifted one. Or maybe all of a sudden there's a flash sale, and if you buy it the second, you know, it's $100. So anyway, whatever. That is your reading for March, and I'll see you in April. And getting all the way to the end of it. I really appreciate your support. If you are interested in other videos, click here. If you are interested in subscribing, go ahead and click here. Hit that notification bell so that you get alerted to when new videos come out, and also when I do surprise live streams. And then if you're interested in winning a free 20-minute video reading personally every month, go ahead and click right here. Mwah!